keep the bag here, Walker.
Power on. You are now plugged in.
Wow. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Plugged In. Woohoo!
We made it.
We are here.
We are in, man.
We are back. When's the last time I've been on Plugged In? It was probably like 2021. Okay, so we are fast forward as damn near 2024, and we are back active, baby. So welcome. If you don't know me, my name is Rakia Brown. Everybody calls me Rocky, you know, a little 1-2, the biggest rock grizzle, you know what I'm saying? But not to be confused with Rocky Balboa, because I'm not a fighter, I'm a lover, you know what I'm trying to say? So this is Plugged In, where we talk about, you know, a little celebrity news. We might get into a little politics, a little global news, and everything else that's hip-hop culture, pop culture, just all that good flash shit. That's what we do here at Plugged In. And most importantly, we plug the people in with all of these amazing people that are in my community and outside of my community that are doing amazing things. Okay, so let's get into it. So first of all, first things first, we're at the Outlet Bar and Lounge, baby. Can we make some noise for the Outlet Bar and Lounge?
Yep. Yes. Shout out to the drink.
Yes. So drinks and hookah are sponsored by the Outlet Bar and Lounge. The Outlet Bar Lounge is located 1304 Monroe Street, Endicott, New York. It is owned by me and my mother. And so, yeah, here we are. Shout out to my mom, Miss Tina. This is definitely her place to be. All right. So, we have some special guests in the building. Special guests in the building. Can we get a drum roll? I used to do a drum roll. Yeah, that's the best drum roll y'all got? I'm going to add in the drum roll.
That was good.
All right.
I'm
going to add in the drum roll sounds in the audio. All right. So, we got a special guest in. Like, how many special guests are here? It's like four guests in the building. So we're just going to go through what's your name, where you're from, what do you do? Okay. We're going to start with you because you were the original guest invited here.
Yeah, so my name is Masai. My pronouns are he, him. I was hoping that if I brought enough guests, I could sit off behind the camera because usually I'm behind the camera, but that did not work. So thank you for allowing us the space and letting me come on. But I'm a local organizer, troublemaker, agitator, depending on who you ask. But basically, like everyone here, we do different versions of community work.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Thank you for coming, by the way.
No, thank you
this
for inviting
guy,
us.
Hold on. This guy never is on camera. Okay. Right. So I'm honored that he is my first guest here on Plugged In. Let me just say that. All right. Let's go through.
My name is Dahlia. Mm-hmm. My pronouns are they, she. I like to call myself a woman of many talents.
Okay.
I'm a creative. I rap, poetry, I make music.
Speaking to the Casamigos.
But I'm also primarily a organizer on their big
team. Nice. Very, very nice. And then.
Hi, my name is Salka Valerio. I use she, her pronouns, and I am a community organizer and activist, community organizer at Citizen Action. Activists on the street.
That's right. My name is Passion. I'm an artist, creative. Also do, I like being involved in different community events around the area. But these are two OGs right here.
But you an activist.
These goats right here. These are definitely the goats over here. So I'm really happy you guys all be here today. How's everybody feeling? How you guys doing?
Good. I'm feeling good.
You should be bartending more because I didn't know you made drinks like this.
Yeah, that's cheers. Yeah, I'm definitely a bartender low key. I mean, you guys, y'all have a bartender when you know what I'm saying? But honestly, I get so aggravated. I can't. Like, with drunk people, I get so aggravated.
That's me. Oh, see, I be here on Tuesday. I'm here Tuesday. Yeah. You usually don't bartend on Tuesday.
Oh, no. I can't. Too many people. That's a little snake. Okay, so we got a lot to get into today, just a little bit of time. So first of all, this is a top 10 countdown. Let's rewind. This is 106 and Plugged In right now, okay? Because we still in a little flavor from 106 and Park. I loved 106 Park growing up. So we bringing the vibes back. We running that back right now in 2023, okay? So with that being said, we got 10 videos we got to get through, 10 songs, 10 local artists that we got to get through and give some flowers to. The purpose of the countdown is to pretty much show love to local artists that's out here doing their thing, grinding, spending that money on studio time, music videos. You know, it's a lot that goes into this, Passion. You know?
Oh, yeah.
How much money you spend in a studio in a month?
I've looked at my Cash App because it tells you how much money you spend.
Oh, it's sickening, right? Oh, yeah. I know. I only get a little taste of it, but it's like I literally know. So I'm trying to give flowers to y'all, give y'all something to look forward to, give y'all something to work towards. So let's get into it. So
I guess it's time to get into it, right?
Yeah.
It's time for the top 10 countdown.
Oh, God. Okay, so let's bounce over to here and see who's number 10. Do you guys have any guesses?
Oh, number 10?
Yes.
This 10? Is local music.
Local musicians. Don't think about it number-wise. Just who should be on the countdown?
Who should be on the countdown?
Passion should be on the countdown.
Facts.
Diamond should be on the countdown.
First of all, also, you guys are supposed to submit your music.
Oh,
wow.
That's
how
we're
lagging on that. Okay, because I really wanted to hear that Wagner song.
That's okay, good. Now submit y'all music for the December countdown. That's how it's going to go. We're going to have submissions once a month. There's only one countdown a month. No cheating. Oh, my God. All right, so let's get into it. The number 10 video is, drum roll, please. We got Edge and Baby Lou.
With yes! I might have to catch a body. Killer, killer. Maybe you should get to know me. Killer, killer. I might have to catch a body. Body, body, body. Killer, killer. Yeah. Baby, you should get to know me. Killer, killer.
Hey bitch, I put that on my soul and I ain't slowing down. I'ma always get this paper just to throw around. I'ma always come through tripping like a 100,000. Like a brick up out the kitchen when you bust it down. She never had a nigga that could put it down. Please just play your position, don't say you love me now. I just got another shipment for 100 pounds. I'm like a brick up out the kitchen when you bust it down.
Don't need no gas, so start to park it. Just let me put it on you, you gon' like it. Just wanna know, do I matter to you? Or do I matter to you? Or do I matter to you? It don't even matter when I put it on you. I'm gonna matter to you. I'm gonna matter to you. Just wanna know, do I matter to you?
Back, that was the number 8 video. Her name is Cayenne Cologne. She is out of New York City. I'm not sure which borough. I don't know her. She just actually emailed me her song and it was lit. It was fire. So I threw that in the countdown. So that was your number 8 video. Shout out to Chai's Mixtape. He was in at number 9 with Ice. And we're gonna get back into the show. All right. So first segment, I got some new segments happening. If y'all got better names for them and whatnot, let me know. Because I'm looking for new names for the segment. But this is what I'm calling the Rocky Report. It's where we just report on celebrity news and see what's going on out in the blogs, what's all happening, okay? So, first things first, Andre 3000 dropped a new Flute album.
Woo-hoo! Yo, first of all, that's what's up. When I seen and read that he was like dropping a new album, I got so hyped because I really thought it was words. Until somebody was like, nah, it's a Flute.
It's a Flute.
I was a little disappointed, but still.
That's fire, though.
Yeah, Andre 3000 is fire, and he believes, like, in, like, you know, like, spirituality. He's mad woke, like, super zen.
What is more iconic than a Flute album?
I'm excited.
He just playing the Flute.
I listened to it today.
Kenny G did the saxophone. Shit, why
Andre 3000
can't do the Flute?
Okay, so the album's called New Blue Sun, okay? And it dropped today, November 17th. When y'all watching this, it's not going to be November 17th no more. But it's November 17th, the day that it dropped, which is ironic because it was his first album in 17 years, they're saying. And his first solo album?
Yeah.
He never had a solo album on his time.
So the album 17 years ago was Speaker Box. Uh-huh. And that just became the highest selling rap album of all time. So nice. I feel like it makes sense for him to go in a different direction because what are the odds you're going to strike to do that again? You already got the best-selling album ever. You might as well grab a flute and see what happens. So I'm excited about it. now he's gonna have the best-selling flute album of all time. So.
Right. But what's crazier is like 17 years is already like more than half of my life.
You don't got to brag.
No, it just makes me feel unseasoned. Like it's not a flex. Like, you don't even know nothing about OutKast, bro. Yeah. If his last album was 17 years ago.
Yeah, that's wild.
I mean, how old was I?
Damn.
We don't got to do all the math.
Anyway, we're not going to get on to it. All right, so next up, Diddy's in the scandal. Oh, Diddy scandal.
I saw that.
What the hell's going on with P. Diddy? Sean Combs. So let's get into it. So Sean Combs is accused of, accused by Cassie of rape and years of abuse in a lawsuit. In the suit, the singer says Mr. Combs, known as Puff Daddy or Diddy, subjected her to a pattern of control and abuse for over a decade. Mr. Combs denied the allegation. Okay, so Diddy's denying the allegations, and apparently this was a secret investigation by the NYPD. But the NYPD came out and said that there's no such investigation underway, so they don't know what everybody's talking about, but they do support rape victims. So if you've ever been a victim of rape, they encourage you to come forward. However, they're not aware of this investigation. So what are our thoughts on that?
That's wild. Like she said, she even like mentioned that, you know, sex trafficking was involved, that like he would have sex with people and he would watch. I don't really know what to
that's a lot
to think of. It is really heavy.
It is,
and you know, I'm always on the side of believing survivors, right? Period. Like, you know, I'm never doubting nothing. So
and I mean, Diddy's a little sus, right?
A little sus. All right, Diddy was dating Cassie when she's 19 and he's 37. So right off bat, that's like a major red flag.
Yeah,
okay. he should have been canceled then. Everybody know Diddy killed Tupac like 25 years ago.
I got something to say.
Nah, but I'm just saying. So we know.
Y'all generation. Y'all not Kelly. We didn't kill Tupac. Y'all not Kelly cut loose.
First of all, we was kids. We ain't know nothing about who was going on.
Who was adults back then? What's the age bracket?
I don't think none of us were.
It's a certain age bracket that's responsible for all this that was going on at this certain time.
That's Gen X. That's on them.
Yeah, that's on them.
Everybody got cut loose back then. OJ on the run, you know? Like, what's going on back then in those days? But not, that was a whole different era.
With Cassie though, this is a civil suit. It's not a criminal suit. So no matter what happens, they talking about, you know, they're trying to say that she's trying to extort him for $30 million or whatever. But the statute of limitations is likely expired on most of that stuff. Mm-hmm. I feel like obviously she's telling the truth, and this is her way to get this to the public, because he got all the money in the world. Mm. No matter what happens, he's not going to be. Right. You can't cancel a billionaire. That's impossible. He could just buy an island and be ghost, and that's it. So I'm glad she came forward, and this has been a long time coming. Everybody knows Diddy is trash. Like, it's like we all knew it. Yeah. So
it's terrible, Diddy. You know, you had it coming.
Yep.
Yeah. I don't like ugly.
Listen, was he done in the dark?
Gonna come.
Hello, somebody.
Mace was right.
Somebody.
We sorry, Mace. He was
wrong. We sorry, Mace. I mean, we sorry to how many people are we sorry to?
Everybody. Mace, we don't even Black gotta be Rob, sorry, Shine, everybody. J-Lo.
I mean, the list goes on, and we really all knew, but I guess it's like, what are you going to do? I don't know. We should have canceled them.
We should have canceled
them. Now it's
too late. He got Lifetime Achievement Awards. And
that's a fact.
Oh, God, this is bad. Okay, this is really bad. This is bad. All right, so we're going to move on from that topic. Diddy,
you're dead bad.
So we're here. We have our guests here. So I definitely want to talk to you guys about what you guys got going on. So first of all, if you don't mind, can we talk about the transition from plot to what's happening now? Let's talk about that. Let's talk about the then. Let's talk about the now.
I'll get into that because I guess it's like a little messy, but not really. I mean, no, this is good. I feel like these are the type of questions you should ask. Mm-hmm. But basically, it doesn't matter what organization it is. If it's a leftist organization, mm-hmm. chances are at some point it's going to dissolve. And, right. and a lot of times that's by design.
Right.
If you look at the Black Panthers, mm-hmm. you look at SNCC, you look at even the NAACP isn't what it used to be decades ago. So, mm-hmm. you know, Plot had a really good run. And then, you know, COVID hit. And people had to do things, and it kind of, like, to an extent, dissolved. Mm-hmm. And, you know, new things came out of it. Mm-hmm. The good part, though, is, like, all those networks that were built still exist. So it's just like at the university.
It's like a rebirth. That's what I'm saying. I wasn't trying to be messy, but asking the question. No. I love what's going on. I think it's a fine evolution. And so what's the cat? There's no name. Mm-hmm. The logo's cat. I'm going to flash the logo on the screen for them. I think I'm going to try to do it. Right? Isn't it?
Yeah, no,
so tell me about it. What's the backstory to that?
A bunch of new groups, I think, popped up after COVID started to kind of at least dissipate to the point where we could still organize again in rooms. So there's a bunch of different organizations that came out of it. But one space that came out of it about May was this, the cat, whatever, you know, we don't really have a name for it.
But, I love that. That's iconic. That is
it's like the Power Rangers.
Yes. And I saw like a little meme and it was like, you know, I want you to be part of my new group. And it's like, well, what's the name of it? There is no name. It's just a cat. And it's like, count me fucking in. And it's like, yes.
We all like cats.
Rally the truth.
Everybody who has a cat knows that cats know something we don't.
I hate cats. We don't all like cats. I will voluntarily be the oddball out. I hate cats.
Well, you go across the world, look at even ancient Egypt and like in, you know, indigenous cultures. There's like cats, people be thinking they know something, right?
Right.
And so we felt like that might be a good symbol. But it's just one of the other groups that have popped up, and there are a bunch of them, but when we kind of came together, our first thought was like we should do some youth outreach and youth engagement and just kind of get back into that organizing capacity where we're really just interacting with the community, the people who are most vulnerable, most marginalized, because even in the absence of Plot or Antifa or whatever that they're calling it, you know, at any given day, there needs to be people
they
like coming together.
Antifa. Oh, you mean like?
Yeah, they called us. I got called a terrorist today.
We got called terrorists. First of all, Rich David named this all by name, calling us terrorists on the news.
Shame on you.
Yep.
Rich David. Is Rich David okay? First of all, I've been feeling overwhelmed, like trying to keep up with politics and everything that's going on.
Yeah.
So, like, local politics. Rich David is still currently nothing.
Right.
Okay. He should get a job, honestly.
He should get a job.
He's a drain on the economy. He needs to pull himself up from his bootstraps.
Facts. Stop living off of people.
Yep. Not using their lines on them.
He's a welfare queen. Right.
Yeah, he definitely is a welfare queen.
I cannot. So, what are some of the biggest challenges you guys would say in community organizing in 2023?
I think every year is a challenge. Like, there's no, like, difference, I feel like. I feel like every year there's a challenge when it comes to organizing. It just looks different. I know coming out of COVID, I felt like there was, like, a lot of work to get people outside and back out into the streets and into rooms. I really feel like my favorite thing about organizing is everybody being in the room.
Right.
Like, so when COVID was happening and we had to do like Zoom meeting and things like that, it was just a little bit off, you know? And when it comes to like organizing, like the whole point is being in the room with different people and making, you know, getting plans together.
Yeah.
Yeah, beyond their sort of like things, I feel like after COVID, especially a lot of their like younger generation, the way they got exposed to organizing was through Zoom calls. I remember like the fact that like people were like watching out on George Floyd, the only way that they were able to like learn about that was online. So you have a whole generation of like younger people, like the only way that they know how to engage through like politics is through like social media. That is like sort of booming things, right? Like we're the most interconnected generation in history of anything. So we can like if we really wanted to, we can get anything.
Right.
But like
so how would you guys define organizing? Like, what does it take for you to call yourself an organizer?
Well, because I feel like it's related to music a lot. That's the only reason. Because I got into organizing through music, and I feel like so did you. So,
you guys are related to music. Do you agree with that, Sofa?
I don't know. I came from a different experience.
Right, of course.
So I didn't come
But I think that
music.
Connection that made is sense. Interesting. Talk to me about it.
No,
come on,
I refuse.
Tell me about it.
I want.
Come on. Oh, come on, Passion. No, I think I agree with you. Come on, let's start trouble.
I mean, anything like when you're just organizing anything, you need the 5 W's, where, when, why, I guess. So like watching the side and then watching Sulfa do like how they interact with the community. Mm-hmm. Like I've learned a lot of things through organizing. And it's the same thing to just sharing stuff on social media, telling people about it, going out to different places, like actually getting on the streets and talking to the people and handing out flyers and stuff like that. I think that's like a big part of organizing. You do that like with music too, like you're organizing like a show or anything like that. You're going out, like
organizing your fan base, period. You know, trying to get that support system, that foundation. Word.
So the overlap. That's exactly what I was talking
about. Overlays, right? Because that's how, like, me and Didi get involved, yep. And it's just everybody who's doing everything just
gets not a secret. You got to promote. You got to be out there. You got to have flyers. You got to make it fun and engaging. It doesn't matter if you're throwing a protest or an album release party.
Right.
The overlap is there between organizing for the community, social justice, and organizing for music or any sort of theatrical thing. You're doing the same stuff. You're reaching
right.
people in the same mm-hmm. ways. Just like they have commercials
right.
on TV for, it doesn't matter what the product is,
right.
they know they got to
get
it to people. So the flyers, the street teams, the social media promotion, the canvassing, making it fun, entertaining, engaging, visible, like
right.
all those things matter. Whatever you're pitching to people, it's the same thing. So people who
true.
Come from artistic backgrounds, even you
mm-hmm.
you know, y'all own a club. How do you get people here? It's the
right.
same way I get
same
people in the streets.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same way Passion gets people to the shows.
Right.
It's the same way the
I
students
like
get people there. It's the
yeah.
same
I
stuff.
Like that.
It's
we are
fact.
All
it's
organized. We all need to join. We all need to do this together.
Yeah. And moms, by
all
the way,
of it.
That's why I think mothers are good organizers, because the same way you get your kids to the school and you get them to the games and after school activity,
yeah,
mothers make the best organizers
because
they used
oh,
to do
God.
8 things at once and then you know.
Oh God, I'm terrible. I'm stressed and struggling.
You run
baby.
A whole podcast and you got
oh,
a whole.
Oh God,
kid.
I know it's really
that's
a lot.
That's organizing.
That's organizing. It's a lot going on.
Yeah, then when you tap in deeper, like to get people invested, is having creating relationships, having one-on-ones with them,
mm-hmm.
you know, getting to their self-interest on
right.
how they want to, you know, help elevate the work. So,
mm-hmm.
right, once you got that, that's the recipe right there.
All right. So, let's get into, we're going to get back into the countdown. We're going to do the number 7 video. Number 7 and 6 video is coming up. So number 7, we have Winna Scales with his song Aura. Woohoo! Y'all don't know Winna Scales? Wow.
Yeah.
All right, come on. Let's get into it.
They can stay like a kid full of paint. Your bitch broke, she get minimum wage. My chain sweat like I play for the race. Bitch just swallow the dick I would taste. Cast me green like it's only one race. Asian bitches, she born in a bay. She like gunners and blickers and shakes. Oh my God, what did I just do? I just stopped in a tank. She wanna end up in a whole cooking choco. She want the boy right out the gate.
Shut me out cause you're alone inside. Just open up and let go of your pride. Baby, come, can you feel me? You got me hooked to the feeling. Let's make love, get you healing. You don't have to leave right now. Baby, come, can you feel me? You got me hooked to the feeling. You wanna come get the real thing? I know how to shut it down.
All right, so that was the number 6 video. We got Diamond Denali with 1211. So shout out to Diamond. I know y'all Uncle Diamond Denali. Shout out to Diamond Denali.
Yes.
You see, you just dropped your new rap song, like big
time. I didn't even know she rapped until I seen a little trailer.
She's going crazy right now.
Yeah.
She's
yeah,
going crazy right
dope.
Now.
That was
and
dope.
I gotta tell y'all a secret, not even a topic. She's my next Freestyle Friday.
Too.
Oh,
yay!
Oh,
yes,
I'm
excited. The beat fire. She's gonna go crazy. I'm really excited. Okay, boom. So that was that. So now it's time for politics for the people. Woo, politics for the people.
We politics.
Come on, it's politics for the people. We
okay.
gotta clap for educating black
got
people
you.
On politics.
Right, I'm with you there.
That's what it's all about. Let's have a drink to that. Cheers. Okay.
I done guzzled
okay.
my drink.
So I done guzzled my drink. Okay, on the next break, we gotta refill our cups.
Yeah.
That's what's happening. Okay, so positive people. War in Israel for dummies. What's going on?
Depending who you ask.
Let's start
with the name. Like, it's a genocide in Palestine. Is
okay.
It is. So Israel, I mean, depending who you ask, shouldn't even really be there. It wasn't Israel until, you know, after my mother was born. It's a new
right.
state.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
Okay, educate me, because I did not know that.
It's very, oh, go ahead.
Yeah.
It's just like, there were people living there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're like, indigenous Palestinians living there. So then you have a group of people, like, who are not related to that, who come in and occupy that place. Like, your entire, where you live is
mm-hmm.
basically, like, colonized.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, it's, like, changing owners.
Okay.
So they're saying, like,
so similar to what happened to America, like Native Americans getting
yeah.
genocided out, and now Christopher Columbus discovered America.
And that's exactly why the United States is on the side of Israel, because we are the same. We, you know, we have the same interest in fights.
Got you. Okay, so this changes everything, right? So they're portraying it in the news as something kinda that is really not.
Yeah, and even calling it a war is disingenuous. They don't realize, like, Palestine, you know, used to have millions and millions of people, but a lot of them have been slaughtered and displaced. So when we talk about Gaza versus Israel, Israel is now a massive place that used to be Palestine between the River Jordan and the Mediterranean Sea. Okay. That's a big land area of land. Mm-hmm. Gaza is the size of Detroit. It's tiny. So you can't really have a war versus a city versus a whole state, right? Mm-hmm. So even using the word war is wrong. That would be like saying the United States versus Binghamton. That's not a war.
Okay.
That's a genocide, right?
So what's happening right now is just the continuation of the genocide.
Yeah, they're trying to ethnically cleanse, eradicate those Palestinians.
Unbelievable. This is why it's politics for the people, because if my fellow black people turn on the news, that's not what they're going to see.
Yeah. No, they're not going to see that. And this has been going on, was it 1948? Was it
1947?
When Israel essentially began taking over.
This is terrible.
And this has been going on for so long. You can find quotes from the Black Panthers supporting Palestine. You can find quotes from Martin Luther King supporting Palestine. We're extending that tradition today because this has been going on for that, 50 plus years, or 70 plus years. And that's still new, though, for a nation. So it's not like Israel has been there the whole time and this is their land.
This is unbelievable. This is really unbelievable. This is really, like, heart-shattering. So then my next question is, let's run it back to Kanye getting canceled because he said that, the Hebrews are not the true Hebrews and the Israelites, all that. Doesn't that all kind of tie in together? And what do you guys think about the statement that he made? And did he deserve to be canceled for it?
I think these aren't really religious issues. We're trying to think of it in that sense. But even in the land right now, in Palestine, Israel, they're not like,
Jews versus...
That's not what it is. We tend to think of it that way here, but that's really not what it is. First of all, everyone in that region is Semitic. So so there's no such thing as, it's anti-Semitic against Jews and not the Arabs. Like, everyone there is Semitic. That's based on linguistics and region. So should Kanye be canceled? Probably for like 10 things I can think of.
Right.
But that's such a small thing in the scope of...
Right.
What's actually happening over there.
But so, I mean, like, do you think that, because I feel like they will try to gaslight, they'll cancel you for saying some real shit. You get what I'm trying to say?
I don't think necessarily what he said was real, because, like, Jews are one of the biggest groups fighting for Palestinians right now.
Okay.
So this isn't really like Jews versus Arabs or Jews versus Palestinians. Right, in fact, Jews versus for peace. We had Jews at the Palestine rally a couple weeks ago. So I hate when it's framed that way, because I think people sometimes conflate Israel with Jews, and that's not true. Jews fuck with Palestinians. Like, most Jews are especially in the United States, they're leading in ways these demonstrations in support of Palestine. Mm-hmm. So when Kanye says something anti-Semitic against Jews, that's not really helping the movement, because Jews are at the forefront of this movement. So Kanye still, like, was out of pocket for that.
Okay. So then where does the whole idea that, like, black people are the original Hebrews, or we're the original Jews, where does that stem?
Anyone want to take that?
I feel like that's just patriarchy, insecurity. That's a fact.
Black people are the original a lot of things, but sometimes people just be throwing that shit out there, honestly.
Okay. So,
black people are the original Vikings. You heard it here first.
Right.
Like, not really.
So let's get into local elections. Local elections just happened out here, and they happen all over country, right?
Yeah.
It's all around the same time, so all of you should have been dealing with your local elections just recently. Let's do a recap and get into the importance of local politics.
First, I do want to shout out that one of the Central Park Seven, he's on City Council in New York City. That was kind of dope. So, shout out to that, to the winner. I forgot his name, but the local politics as far as the election stuff here. We finally took back city council, which was super dope. The last meeting I went to, we was there for the school stuff, for the tax break that they was trying to give somebody. And I remember when I was there, I was like, we're going to make sure we get all y'all up out them seats. Mm-hmm. And we actually did.
Right.
So that was pretty dope.
Can we clap it up for them?
So we is Citizen Action. the Democratic Committee, our canvassers that volunteered, knocked on doors, phone banking. It was a lot.
I imagine so. And it was a lot of votes that came through. When I did my research on like the numbers, it was like thousands and thousands of people popped out to do that. So I think you guys did really amazing work. And I think you guys really flipped the city. I'm born and raised in Binghamton. And it's like, it wasn't always like this. I feel like Black people, first of all, we wasn't paying attention. I'm going to be honest. We weren't even paying attention to go out to the votes to know who to vote for. We just was getting the news. The new mayor was the new mayor. So-and-so was the new so-and-so. Maybe I was just too young to be paying attention, but that's how I feel. I feel like when you guys came and started a movement, I feel like there's just so much more awareness now of who the politicians are, what they stand for, what we need to be doing. I feel like we just didn't know what we needed to be doing.
That's a consequence of organizing in general. So even if you're organizing just to radicalize folks, people get involved in politics and they start voting. I personally, I don't want to take credit for that election thing because I didn't vote. I don't vote. But I do commute. I don't vote. And I'll get into that in a second if you even care.
No,
but just organizing for the community, people are going to start paying attention. And I feel like a lot of times radicals, communists, people who may not be engaged in electoral politics, we still bring folks in to the fold because not everyone is going to jump to a meeting or be out here, you know, getting arrested or doing demonstrations or, you know, giving food out in the community. Some people just want to get engaged in the easiest way or the most accessible way.
Right.
And a lot of times that's voting. So even though I don't be out here advocating for voting necessarily, a lot of people that, that fuck with me, they vote because they're like, I wasn't paying attention before. Now I am.
Right.
So I don't hold nothing against people who decide to vote. It's not necessarily my thing.
Right.
But I support anyone who's paying attention and wants to be politically engaged.
Right. So you don't vote. Tell us why.
I'm just busy. I'm just lazy. No, I feel like, I don't want to be involved in the electoral process because I think it's a farce. I got called for jury duty yesterday, right?
Okay.
I don't believe in cops. I don't believe in judges. I don't believe in courts. I'm not going to serve on jury duty. Now, some people will say, that's your civic duty.
Right.
You're supposed to do that. I see it as a privilege because they said they was going to pay me $40 a day to do it. A lot of people can't quit, you know, stop going to work for 2 weeks and get $40 a day. And that's a privilege to be able to do that. So I don't want to be involved in that type of system because I don't believe in it.
Right.
So that's the same reason I really don't get involved with voting. I don't want my tax dollars going to the war, the genocide in Gaza. So why would I vote for people who I know are going to put my money towards those things? Democrat or Republican, they all send in the money over.
So then I'll spin it to you. You guys are like the best of pals. Selco rallies us up to go out and vote. Y'all not the best pals? Yes, y'all.
We are, but he gets on my nerves all the time.
All the time.
So what?
All the time.
That's his job. That's what you do.
That's not what
my
take on it is that to me, I feel like this is the system that we're in right now, right? So how I look at it is because this is the system that we're in right now, until everybody wake the fuck up and say, hey, we're going to just stop doing this and we all going to be together, go out into the streets. I would like that for it to happen, but since it's not, this is the system that we're in.
I feel like if we don't
go out and at least vote for the most progressive people that we can, the other side gets to win and they make the decisions for us.
Right.
So that's pretty much how I look at it.
So I guess it's like, why don't we put some of the energy into just starting our own communities and our own thing? I feel like if we look back at Black history, like I watch documentaries and stuff all the time, like, you have the stories of like Tulsa, Oklahoma, where, and although the oppressors got us, wowzers, you know, but, you know, we had those communities, or like the Muslim leaders back in the day, God forgive me, I can't remember his name at the moment, but the Muslim leaders back in the day, they always wanted us to have our own stuff. Black Panthers always had our own hospitals and food programs and stuff like that. We kind of created our own system. So why don't we put more energy into trying to build that back rather than that? Now, I don't think one is either right or wrong, because I hear what you're saying too. I be saying the same shit to myself sometimes. Like, I mean, we could complain about the system all day, but it is what it is. So let's just do what we can to try to change it.
I mean, it's been around since I don't know how long.
It's wrong. And Black people, I think it's nowhere for us to win in that system, honestly.
You want
to
jump in?
I feel like that's what y'all are doing already.
Right.
I agree like almost completely. Like, I don't believe in electoral politics either, but like the fact that we are in a world, and we are living in a country, but that is a dominant form of way that people engage with, like, the structures that govern us around them. So we have to understand that there's a way that we have to engage with that. At the same time, we can also build our own community.
Right.
Like every time we have, it's just been like shut down.
Right.
It doesn't mean that we can't do it again.
Do it again.
Right. And I feel like what we do is pretty much is leading up to that. Right. Political education is important. Making people aware of things is right. super important. I know, like, from years ago when I moved to Binghamton, well, to this city, I call Endicott and Low and shit Binghamton. But since I moved here, the landscape have really changed a lot. When I first moved here, it was quiet. Nobody wasn't doing nothing. And me, a person that come from when I get irritated about certain things, I make shit happen to me to change it. So I was looking around. I'm like, why there's no black people doing shit? Why people not sitting around certain tables? Why everybody is quiet when there's an injustice happening? And I started paying attention to that. And I just started networking with people to see, like, what the fuck is really going on in this city that everybody just allow these things to happen.
Right, yeah. Coming, like, being, like, from Binghamton, being born and raised in Binghamton, and I left for a minute. I think Elka had moved here, like, while I was gone. So I moved back in 2019, and I just watched, like, how I was like, wait, this wasn't going on. Like, there was a lot of stuff that had, like, changed. And I feel the same way when it comes to voting, like, how Rob feels, but I also feel like I got involved in the politics because I wanted, like, stuff to change. This was my first time I ever voted on city council. Like, it's the only vote that I feel like actually would count, you know, flipping the city council. And the whole reason I got involved in it, like, into, okay, what's going on with politics is because I think it was the protests they were doing for the sewage plant. The company from Flint, Michigan wanted to buy, who, like, poisoned Flint, Michigan's water, had put a bid in for the sewage plant out here.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, like, I didn't know. And I'm like, wait, so
we gotta pay attention.
Involved, like, so that's why
we gotta pay attention.
I got involved in the politics.
Which brings me to my next question is, like, what advice would you guys give to just, I'll say, young black people like myself? Like, I try to pay attention as much as I can because I'm a young journalist and I'm trying to really, I swear it's like my life's mission right now. I try to watch the news on any of my free time and just get into it. But it's like, I have a different kind of brain, I guess. I say I'm ADHD. I'm not diagnosed. But, like, my brain doesn't, like, I could watch the news for an hour and learn, like, you know, 10% of what they said actually was received. Versus, like, I love documentaries, or I love to learn history through that. But current events is not history, right? So it's not anything documented yet to go back and watch. So I'm trying to just keep up with as it's happening. How do we stay in tune? Like, what do we do? Because I feel bad. I'm always texting sucker, what's going on, sucker? I got to write a story on this, sucker. I need help. What's going on? But it's like, sucker's only one person. So we have to be able to, I need to be able to educate myself. So now when my peers ask me a question, I don't have to go to sucker. I can just dump this out. Or even when I got to write a news story, I could just, like, how do we pay attention? Like, how do we do this? Like, how do we know that that's happening? Where did y'all hear that was happening? You know?
Plugging yourself in.
With what?
Like,
wait, what website did you find that on? That the people are bidding to buy the sewage plant.
I heard it through word of mouth, and I just did my own research on it. Right. I was like, oh, let me see. I don't think it's true. So I just Googled, and I looked. I was like, oh, this is happening. And that's where, like, I actually seen a lot of people coming together with the protest. Like, it was just a lot of hope.
And that was due to outreach, right? Social media, just getting the word out to the people. And so pretty much from organizers. So knowing who's organizing in your community, seeing what events are up, you know, plugging yourself into the events, coming to shows, coming to just these different type of opportunities, like mutual aid events or whatever, and then just being curious, right? And then doing your own research, because not everything that I hear, I believe. Once I hear something, I go back and do my own research and be like, oh, okay. And then, what's your self-interest, right? Like, what is your self-interest? And whatever your self-interest is, that's how you plug yourself into the movement.
And specifically in Binghamton or in the surrounding area, if you want to get plugged in, like Salka said, the best way is to come to events. But if you just want to know what events are happening and where you can come, follow folks on social media. Follow Salka, follow Passion, follow me. Your page and your podcast is going to be another avenue for people to get plugged in. If you'd rather get an email, if you go to tinyurl.com/bingthings, it's tinyurl.com/bingthings. It's a mailing list of local events that are progressive in nature. So if you want to know about those things, you can follow that. So it's really just get plugged into whatever, in whatever capacity you can.
Right.
And if you have a softie in your life, send her a text just like you do. There's nothing wrong with that. People text me all day long. You know, that's how we even were able to coordinate this. So that's cool too.
It's such a blessing. It's like part of your purpose. I know you, it gets on your nerves, but it really
It doesn't get on my nerves.
It has to. Because I've been thinking about you. I got mad empathy for everybody.
It doesn't.
I'm an over-empathy. But what was I going to say? So yeah, definitely. I'm trying to work on pluggedinmedia.com. So what I'm trying to do with Plugged In is like make it like, you know how we have the Shade Room, right? Which shout out to the Shade Room. But come on, Shade Room. Like, they be trying to do a little politics, and they do. But I feel like I want to have a tab on my website that's specifically about these type of issues and what I think Black people need to be paying attention to. And I think if more local entrepreneurs or stuff like that, we need platforms, because it's easy to say go to the events and do all this stuff. But realistically, I know people that ain't even thinking about this shit to be even thinking about going to no event. They just not thinking about it. We need to put it in their face. Like, you know, the same way we're showing the numbers in our face, we need to put this stuff in their face.
The revolution will not be televised.
That
means the people in power are not going to put this information out there. So it's on us to build these structures through various media outlets and our own creativity, our own writing, student journalism, independent media. That's how we're going to get this out. And there's a long tradition of this.
That's my purpose. Yes, God. That's Amen. Amen.
This is a long tradition from comics, like the political cartoons, to Negro spirituals sung in the fields. This is how we shared information. It wasn't always the oppressor putting it out there. It was us finding creative ways to get that out there.
Yes.
So thank you to you for giving this.
Yeah, this is a part of
God, man. I don't got nothing to do with it. I don't know what's going on. He just told me to do this. This is what I'm doing.
This is definitely part of it.
Ooh, so yeah, okay, so let's get back into the countdown. We are at the what's the last videos we did? Look, I don't lose the count.
Diamond Denali's up.
Diamond Denali. Okay, so we are at the number five video. We in the middle, baby. That's we great. In the middle. So number five video is 2M Fen. Shout out to 2M Fen, Big Fen, Little Fen. We got Drinking and Driving. Hey,
okay, don't do it.
I know, right?
Don't drink and drive.
The big two, I ain't talking about no shortstop. Inky gray bottom, summertime, I'm in a tank top. No cash, but my phone hold a ransom. Pretty paid nigga, but the missus call me Benzino. Drinking and driving, but I'm smooth, don't panic. Open up the top, good views, panoramic. I'm blessing Holly Fibber, yeah, I put that on my granny. Started off as friends, loyalty that make you family. Couldn't be stuck, get a bag, have a plan B. Drippy ass nigga came outside looking fancy. I grab a bitch ass, slam it down like I'm Randy. Beat it like Mike Jack, is you okay, Andy? Come through, tell your friends they can sleep over. I heard what you said, but you can come closer. I got the living room for them new sofa. You be coming to test cause you move over. I was told I can make time with you and your friends. We going back and forth, are we doing this again? Speak that. I know your ex-man is a waste man. Tell me while I'm rubbing on your feet then. Voice is really shaky when you're speaking. Saying it used to be him, but it ain't no more. I just like you, can we close that up to that?
All right, so that was the number four video. We had Maddie with Hiatus. Give it up for Maddie, y'all. Give it up for Maddie. Just so that y'all know, Maddie is the local engineer. He engineers everybody's songs. You know, shout out to Chives. Also, he was also on the countdown. He's an engineer as well. So it's really dope that they are not only artists, but they're the engineers behind everybody's music in the town, right? Who you go to record?
That's what recorded my whole life. Actually, both Chives and
recorded. Because they both did my podcast at Time of Five. Oh, shout out to them.
That's dope.
Yes. Okay, so let's get back into the show. So we're going to cut into another segment. It's called Topic of Discussion. So sometimes if you wanted to dumbify Topic of Discussion, it might be sometimes like blue cheese or ranch. Sometimes if it's a big controversy or something like that. But today we're going to get into Coi Leroy and Benzino. Okay, so everybody knows Coi Leroy. Everybody knows Benzino.
Yeah.
Okay, how y'all feel about Coi Leroy, by the way?
I think she's dope.
Like, me too.
Me too.
I like her songs too.
Okay,
I think she's better than her pops.
That's a fact.
All right, so let's rewind. So over the past couple of days, I was watching my interviews because that's what I do. Being on YouTube, looking at conspiracy theories, interviews. This is what I love to do. So I came across an interview with Angie Martinez and Coi Leroy in real life. Do y'all know Angie Martinez in real life podcast?
Yeah.
Incredible. Love her. Shout out to Angie Martinez, the big goat. I'm coming for you, Angie. I'm coming for you. All right, but anyway. So they was on the interview. It was a really good interview. Coi's beautiful, dope girl. I watched it with no problem. You know, I laughed. I cried a little. It was a great time. finish the interview, you know, here goes social media and the blogs. That's what killed me, because I actually watch interviews. So I'll be watching these interviews and I see what the blogs do to it. It's really terrible. You guys have to stop. Just tune into the people's content. This is what artists do interviews for. It's for people to get to know them, and then you guys ruin it. That's another conversation for another day. So Coi in the interview, what did she say? She pretty much was saying that her dad is kind of envious of her. Look, I'm doing it now, right? We're dumbing the interview down to the mixy moments. But yeah, she said that her dad was kind of like envious of her, and that he still kind of got something to say and get off his chest. And she also said she doesn't want to be his clout baby. Okay? You said Coi Leroy is better than Benzino. First of all, let's talk about Benzino. I'm not from that era of Benzino, but I hear he's the GOAT.
What? I don't even remember
what
the song.
Like, so, what was the song? Source Magazine. Benzino was famous. He ran Source Magazine.
Yeah. And he's probably most famous for losing a battle with Eminem. I mean, there's like nobody can name a Benzino song. Yeah.
That's a fact. You know, like,
he came into his industry, he came into it in media, and then he was like, oh, I want to be a rapper, two type situation. Okay. But he never, I mean, he's not known as being like the GOAT of rap. He probably had one single.
I heard he was a goal in the media industry. Yeah. I heard he was a goal in the media industry for Source Magazine and the Source Awards, obviously, was huge in hip-hop.
Yeah.
I wasn't really aware that he was a rapper.
And both of those are gone now, by the way. So now he's most famous for, I think, Love & Hip-Hop or one of those reality shows.
That's how I actually knew him in modern day. I saw him originally on Love & Hip-Hop, and then all the other stuff came up. But doesn't he still get some respect for what he's done in hip-hop? I mean, Source was huge.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really think so. I mean, I don't. I think the Source was huge, but I don't think a lot of people think of Benzino as like a pioneer in really in any industry. Because in addition to the Source, that a lot of people said the Source like bit off. What was that other the rap one? I can't think of the other. It'll come to me later. But like, it wasn't around for that long a time, I think. And him personally, he kind of ruined that. It's gone. Like it's over.
Yeah.
So he never really had the rap career he wanted. And even though the Source may have been like groundbreaking at the time, it went away pretty quickly.
Right.
And that's why I kind of agree with Coi Leroy, where she has the career that he probably thought he wanted or deserved.
Right.
And he also was a deadbeat dad, by the way. I just want to throw that out there. She's mad at him because she said straight up he was so busy with the Source that he wasn't there for her. So that's why I'm on her side already.
Right. And that's a fact. She did definitely say that in the interview. Benzino hopped on Instagram. He pretty much got on the video and said, of course, I called you for money. You're my child. I'm your father.
That's exactly how it sounds. Yo, but who gets on Instagram to talk to your daughter? That's how I know you're deadbeat.
If I gotta talk to my daughter,
I'm not gonna have a Snapchat like, yo, you know. No.
Benzino, he ain't even got a relationship to call her.
Coi was on the video too. She was talking about her life.
X, Y, and
Z again.
You ever heard of Benzino song?
The first time I've heard of Benzino songs, like the whole like
that was the most famous for losing to Eminem.
So he had a rap beat for Eminem?
Yeah, that's probably his most famous song, losing to Eminem.
So I never even when I did my research, I didn't find that. So that's deep in the archives.
No, I'm dead at. One other thing he said in the video was that he asked Coi Leroy for money, and he felt like he's entitled to the money because he's her dad.
This is what he said.
And he's like, this generation don't respect their parents. And I'm thinking, you're supposed to give her money. You're the dad. So he was salty that she got more bread than him. Right? Exactly. He just legend. But he's asking his daughter for money and then got the nerve to say she's spoiled for
that. And I do want to say something else. I searched for his Instagram because I was really trying to pull up a Benzino because it's like, I know you the GOAT down there somewhere. I found his Instagram page, but it was like so like not lit that I thought it was not even his real Instagram page. And that's no Instagram don't mean shit. You could be still a GOAT and not on Instagram at all. But it was just like I could definitely see her narrative being true. Like, you know what I'm saying? Where, like,
bitch, I said what I said.
Oh, God.
That's what she told her dad.
Right. So that's that. So any other opinions on Coi and Benzino situation? You know, Benzino lost again to his own daughter.
He lost again. That's two. He's 0-2.
And what was his... Well, okay, wait. Before we leave the topic, what was his storyline on Love & Hip Hop?
I don't know.
I can't remember. Damn. I was hoping y'all would have money.
You don't really be... We... Yeah.
We into
the hip hop back in the day. Back in the day, y'all didn't watch.
Love and hip hop is new. What are you talking about?
I mean,
when Benzino was compared to when Benzino was rapping, it is. I'm sorry. I don't know nothing about Love and Hip Hop.
I don't really know nothing about Love and Hip Hop.
All right. So I think it's time that we get into the number, not even the number. Hold on. It's the top three. We have made it to the top three of the countdown.
Yep.
How do you guys feel? How do we feel about the countdown so far?
Nice.
I played most of the songs.
A lot
for you
of the
guys
music on there is pretty lit.
I love it.
I love it.
It's all local except for the. Yeah. But just to be clear, you guys can submit music from anywhere. Like literally, and I do mean anywhere, you can submit your music. But you just can't already be a celebrity because it's not for you. You know what I'm trying to say? You already got the clout, you got the numbers, it's not for you. This is for my local go getters that's trying to strive for something.
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah. So, shout out to the non local girl on the countdown, Cayenne Cologne. I think I'm saying your name right, baby girl. Reach out to me, plug in with me. You lit. Come on in for an interview. You very much lit. Okay, so top three, drum roll please. We found my proper stuff. Oh, we got Ty Bigga Burst with Bigga Man.
Yeah.
Hey. Now, let me just tell y'all, honestly, if I was not going to play fair, he would have been number one. Because it's really my favorite song. I play this in my car quite often.
Oh, wow.
But, you know, yeah, I like Ty Burst. Other things. He's shout out to Ty Bigga Burst. That's my guy. All right, let's get into it.
I do what I like to do. Bad bitch, my bro like a two. I be with the strikers too. I be with the life is too. Two bitches, that's combination. Don't make this shit complicated. I take over domination. This dick gon' get nominated. I don't wanna beef with you. I'm on some faster car shit. I could really ruin families on some sabotage shit. If it's smoke, got a blunt. Broski past the cartridge. Keep that shit in the clutch like it's in her armpits. And you know that I can't lie. In Miami, had that fire. J&B is shoot that shot. I can't worry about a cop. Man, you know this shit gon' pop. On the beats, I'm selling crops, and they know that I'm gon' go. Man, this shit can never stop. If it's litty, then it's litty then. Bad bitch bring her kitty in. I don't got that many friends. I cannot trust many men. Who really talking when they said a nigga name? If I fuck another bitch, that's cause she giving better brain. Niggas always crack.
Liquor got me hot, Zach got me faded. Pour a shot, I'ma take it. I'ma bend it over, nigga, I'ma shake it. Don't want your heart, I might break it. If I fuck you, don't say shit. Nope. Work a nigga like a day shift. Sneaky at the nighttime. You know how I like mine. Step in the spot and I'm shaking the room. Most of these bitches can do what I do. I'm getting money, I'm taking your boo.
What?
Sliding through in a coupe. I'm getting money, I'm acting a fool.
What?
Off the juice, I don't know what to do. In the party, they playing my tune. Hop on the beat and they fucking with me. Bitches is not what they claiming to be. Hissy is she sliding a V.
Yep.
Ain't know they was sliding with she. You bitches not ready for me. Mixing us out with the grabba. Don't need a nigga for commas. Bitches be mad, not my problem. I want the bag, I got one. Liquor got me hot, Zach got me faded.
What?
Pour a shot, I'ma take it. I'ma bend it over, nigga, I'ma shake it. Don't want your heart, I might break it. If I fuck you, don't say shit.
Hey.
Work a nigga like a day shift.
Sneaky
at the nighttime. You know how I like mine.
So we are back. Welcome back to Plugged In. That was the number two video. Shout out to Freak Neek. That was number two video. Freak Neek Nighttime. Yes, you gotta clap it up for Freak Neek. That was really good. Shout out to Ty Burst again too, because your song is fire as well. So yes, top three is coming in crazy. I love this. Okay. So we're gonna get up out of here soon. We're gonna get the number one video. We're gonna get up out of here. Really quick, first of all, there was something on my sheet. Okay. So a lot of people don't understand why there are a lot of clashes with the police when doing community advocacy. And honestly, not even just police, but what's the tension, period? Just like, why is it so much like...
Why the police are like antithetical to a lot of the missions that like a lot of the...
Say it again, the anti...
They're just opposed. They don't... Yeah. I don't know. I feel like a lot
they
of
just don't want nobody to say nothing. Just shut up and be a citizen.
How many of us have been arrested in the last 5 years?
I've never been arrested.
Okay, but
I feel
three,
so unseasoned. I told
y'all
unseasoned.
Three of your guests have, right?
I know. Three out of five people
so
staying here.
That's why it's like you said, like there's friction because they keep arresting us. They
and
keep
this history
us.
Repeats itself, right? Yeah. Again, I'm a documentary nerd. They always was arresting community organizers.
Always. And we're not, by the way, we're not out here like hurting people.
You're not.
But they keep arresting us. Like, why is that? Because we have different interests, so
we're not doing nothing bad.
Right.
Like
you're really not.
We genuinely
no, literally,
not.
What are you in the middle of doing when they arrest you? Like, what's the situation?
Sometimes we're trying. Well, you go ahead and speak because you. You
know, I think yours was very public.
Yeah.
Already. So, but one of the things that we were doing was protesting outside of Wegmans. But like I said, when it comes to the police, you got to understand that they have they have to follow orders no matter what, you know. And then we live in a society where it's like you live in you got racial systemic racism. Like the country is rooted in, you know,
right.
Racism. Like it goes back a lot. Like there's a lot of stuff involved with like why there's clashes with the police, and
the police are meant to protect property, not really to protect people or to, you know, for any of that.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is like when you guys are out there, so when what did you do? Like one time I was in the food fighting cafeteria, I threw an apple, the lady called me right-handed, I had to go to ISC.
Right.
You know,
so
what were you guys in the midst of doing that?
Let's move away with the idea that we actually did something wrong.
I know.
A lot of times the police will just come and arrest you because you're doing something that's advocating for someone else, or you're doing something that is a danger to, you know, the status quo.
Right.
So like Salka said, they protect property, but they also protect these systems that make it impossible for us to live here. They protect the landlords. They are the reason that they lock up formula in the supermarket. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody's struggling is part of this system, and the police uphold that system.
Right.
So if we're out there advocating for people,
so just literally simply holding a microphone is what I'm trying to get you to say. You're literally sitting there holding a microphone.
People have been arrested
handed food.
Right? But why? Because they see that as a threat
to the system. That's why I was asking, what are you doing? I know y'all not doing anything wrong.
Right, but people, I was getting into that.
I wanted y'all to be transparent. Like, literally, like, that's even worse than I thought.
Right, like people, or there's an illegal eviction, and we out there to stop the landlord trying to illegally evict the whole family out their apartment. Guess who got arrested? Not the landlord that was evicting that family, the people that were blocking the landlord from illegally evicting that family is the people that got arrested. Right. And that's us protecting
people,
but the police was actually protecting
the property. Yeah. I like that. The police are protecting the property, not the people.
Even though the landlord was in the wrong in that situation.
In that situation, we still were the ones that got tackled down,
pepper sprayed,
arrested.
Really do
where we was
guys.
Really
like,
blocking
really...
an illegal eviction. We wasn't doing anything wrong. We was trying to keep a whole family in their apartment while their landlord was illegally evicting them. And we were the one that got brutalized, got pepper sprayed, got kicked, and got fucking arrested.
So literally, my job is like, I need to be a microphone for this type of shit. Like, people need to know what y'all are saying. Like, I'm putting this on my website. When I spot my website up, I'm serious. I'm putting these stories on my website.
No,
I really am.
I want
everybody to know that this stuff is happening. Now, I'm not the biggest chef, but when I get to where I'm going, I'm telling. I'm blowing a whistle on y'all. Y'all know what that means. I'm being a whistleblower. No, I'm serious.
Because it could be any of us is the thing. So it might be if it's you and your family and the fascist forces, police are coming to throw you in the street, and society says that's okay. Sometimes you need to protect people.
Right.
And that's why I think they come at us. And if we remember that, we can all be in this position. We're all one paycheck away, basically, from being out in the street.
We're
of the belief that children should not be homeless. The police believe if you don't pay the rent,
get
out.
Then get out.
And we want to change that perspective. And sometimes, unfortunately, you have to physically protect people because the police have a monopoly on violence. The state has a monopoly on violence, and they use it against the most marginalized people all the time. And that includes poor black babies, families, mothers, and they just will throw them out without a second thought.
That's a fact. So if you're getting kicked out and you're getting evicted, you can't call the police and be like,
and
I'm getting evicted.
It worked. For all the, you know, all the trouble we got into that night, it worked. They didn't evict that family that night. We bought them more time so that they could get their situations in order. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Right.
Sometimes the supermarket gets shut down for a night and they lose thousands and thousands of dollars. And sometimes you get arrested on the other end. But it works to the extent.
It's an impact. Yeah. It was.
It's better than just letting it go on, you know.
And so that is that the reason why everything took place at Wegmans?
Wegmans was, you know, we can't talk too much about it because it's still like in litigation.
Any
place where, you know, people prioritize it over the well-being of the community, especially those in power and those in privilege, people love Wegmans,
right?
But people don't really care about the families getting evicted.
Right.
So in order to make you care about this thing, I'm going
to come
for the thing
Wegmans.
You care about.
Let's
go. No, for real. People really don't care until it's them.
I want to tell you guys, thank you for your work. All you guys, want to tell you guys, thank you for your work. It's necessary. It's needed. I know it's tiring. I know y'all feel like, you know, how you feel. But the marathon continues. You know what I'm saying? This is y'all God-given purpose. I literally strongly believe that. Like, this is what y'all...
No, we actually tired. We about to quit.
That's a whole...
We need help. We need help.
No,
this ain't my purpose. I should be tailgating somewhere. This ain't what I want to do. I want to be free.
It's not. I mean, the purpose is to create the lane, right? And I really feel, because I thought about this today, the lane is created, right? There's a lot of things popping up in Binghamton. I see a lot more mutual aid programs. I see people trying to organize. You know, I see people doing things without permits, like permission. Like, a lot of things, people have stepped up to take office seats. People have stepped up to do a lot. So a lot of things, the lane has been created. Yeah. I can't do this work forever. Like, I'm about to be, like, you know, I need to.
But you guys are still, like, you know.
I need to sit down somewhere now.
You guys are still the blueprint for us. And Binghamton, now I'm dead ass. You know, now shout out to my mom. Shout out to Miss C.
Yeah, because they paved the way as well.
They paved the way for us. You guys are louder. They did pave the way.
But there's louder people out there that we want to come in. And that's where a lot of students and young people come in, because we can't do this forever. Either we're going to get old and phased out, or they're going to kill us out here. Like, for real.
No.
So we need more people involved. And that's really why we're on the show. That's why we do outreach, is because it really can't be. Don't ever think you're going to leave it, Southwell handle it, you know, Messiah handle it.
Nope.
That's not how it works. We can all handle it together.
Right.
And there's a lane, get in, get plugged in.
That's,
you know,
right. Facts. No, we got to do so. Okay.
I was just about to say, like, I don't think a lot of people who are, like, my age, like, understand that, like, y'all are just not doing it. Like, when y'all do this, it's not like, oh, y'all are the people who do this. You're making that platform.
Yeah.
You're the people that get into it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. Making the platform, making the lane for people to plug themselves in and get into it, like,
even the
that's
resources.
What it's all about.
You need
resources.
A bullhorn, take ours. You need whatever you need.
Right, you need a
I feel like everybody's so wrapped up in their own problems and their own stress and their own, like, people are in such dark spaces that it's like, how could they find it to fight for
the
such a larger
part is,
cause? And it's like, I could barely get out of bed, not me, but I'm saying,
real.
You know, put yourself
that's
in space.
It's real, but I was like that. I came from organizing, I came from that. Mm-hmm. I didn't have like a day where the day. It was just, I'm met with obstacle every fucking single
Harriet
day.
Harriet Tubman was running for slavery.
And all of that was the pain and the struggle for what she was going through, and said, it got to get better. Something has to be done.
Right.
Something, I'm not going to sit here and just fucking cry about the shit.
Right.
I'm going to go figure out how
that's
the fuck exactly. I can
we gotta
put myself in
and, get up and, do
and fix it. You cannot just wallow in
the
it.
The well-being of all of us individually would be better if we came together more as a collective.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
That's so important. And can I just say that to anyone that agrees with that and is like, yo, I'm struggling so much. How can I even get involved? I think a lot of people, when they do get involved, they find that it actually helps them.
It's
a
resource.
Because now you got more people to call on. You got. I watched a baby the other week, just because someone else had to go to a protest, but now they knew me, so I was able to babysit.
Right.
Or sometimes you just need food, and once you get plugged into these things, now you have a little
now
more resources
help.
To
right.
help.
You
right,
are.
Now
so,
you have a little
so if you feel like you can't get into organizing because the struggle is too hard, mm-hmm. I promise you, once you get into organizing, you realize the struggle will actually get a little easier. Because now
like
you got people to help.
That's the truth.
Because you got other people collectively helping you. That's
the
fact.
Struggling together
is
a lot better than struggling
by yourself.
Let's get into it. Amen to that. I feel on a personal level. Like, when I met you guys, you, Chanel, the whole Black Excellence crew, Juneteenth, everything, like, it is really a community. It's a family. Like, you're a freaking superhero to me in my eyes.
Don't say that. You put target on me. No, they think I'm bulletproof.
I don't care, man. I love you, man. I love you. Like, I really do. Like, I think it's admirable that, like, it's Juneteenth. I'm running around. I need water. I forgot water. I'm gonna go get you some water. Like,
we got it. We got it covered. That's not, you know.
It's like, I love that. Like, that is like, we need that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Your men, rest of y'all men, get it together.
I forgot about that, Juneteenth. I forgot.
Yeah, yeah. Like, well,
like,
I'm sorry.
She's like, I need 800 bottles of water. I'm like, all right, we got it.
Ooh, stress. Okay, so I want to talk about the clean slate situation. I saw them talking with Kathy Hochul. I saw that on my way here, literally. So what's that all about?
So,
I didn't really get the chance to research.
So we were working on the clean slate bill for a while. So we means Citizen Action, Vocal New York, just a bunch of other organizations around New York State.
was a lot of people from that were previously incarcerated, even Lala, you know, Stop Rikers Island group. Like, everybody was advocating for the clean slate.
Okay, so that's why she was on the video. Heard.
So clean slate is pretty much when, because, you know, we were basically saying, like, people who have been incarcerated had already did their time, and when they come back into the society, it seems like they're still continuing doing their bid because they can't access housing, they can't access jobs, or none of the things that would help them be stable to be able to stay out of jail. Mm-hmm. So clean slate pretty much give them a second chance and the opportunity where after a while the felonies come off and that doesn't count against you to access housing, to access a job. And that's pretty much what it's about.
That's amazing. We can clap for that. I think we can all clap for that. So one last thing I want to get into before we go, because we're going to come back with that number one video and then we're going to wrap this up. But the presidential race, okay? First of all. No. Yo. I got to get into this with you guys here, because I thought about leaving it off because I'm like, you know, I could talk to somebody else about another week. But I think I got the perfect crew right here, right now to really get into it. The American people are feeling hopeless.
Absolutely.
My personal opinion, Joe Biden is giving us no. Not on any issue, not on any nothing. His leadership skills suck. My opinion. Now, you know, a lot of y'all might have been riding with Biden. However you want to feel about it, that's y'all business. I said what I said because I feel like leadership is leadership. Like, I feel like the great thing about Obama, you can say what you want about him, is like, he showed up for us. Like, anytime we were stressed or worried, he had a speech ready. You know what I'm trying to say? To give us some type of, you could not like it, don't like what he said, but he said he has something to say to his country, to address his nation. I feel like
his approval ratings stayed high, not relatively high. Biden's approval ratings are lower than any president except Trump.
Oh my God.
So you're not alone when you say you don't really, you know.
Where are you at? Like, can we get a little hope? Yes, we can. No, we can't. We can't. We can't. We can't.
It's done.
We're poverty. It's over. It's over. What's going on? What can we say to the people? It's just, who are even the candidates?
I feel like everyone here will give a different answer about that. But what I would say is, don't put your faith in electoral politics, because we got to do this regardless who's in office. I don't want all of our rights to hinge on who wins an election every 4 years. Mm-hmm. I want us to have rights no matter who's in office. And if we don't get them, we're going to have to fight for them.
Right.
So just like we got Biden in office now and everybody thought that was going to change things for the country in a positive way, we're still bombing children. We still have kids in cages. We're still building the wall.
There's no
child tax credit. Y'all still can't afford food, groceries, and your rent. So things did not get better. So how do we build better systems regardless who's in office? Because even if the next great Democrat wins in 4 years or wins next year, 4 years from that, we're going to have to do it again. Right. And then 4 years from that, we got to do it again. I'm sick of that.
Right.
Abortion rights just got revoked. I'm sick of going backwards to go forward. Like,
so it's really just like, fuck the system. We need to build lasting power
that isn't contingent on who gets to vote. We had a whole election during a pandemic. That's not even fair. Why would they do that?
Right.
Like, that's dangerous. Right. And a lot of people couldn't, you know. So I just think we need to be strong regardless of who wins.
Feel that.
I mean, you definitely don't want the conservative rights to win at all either, because if they win, all 50 states are going to be facing losing abortion rights and all of those things. And they already rolled back, what was that thing called again? Not after the abortion, they did, you go to college and...
Affirmative action.
Yes, they got rid of that. Like, just a whole bunch of crazy things. And yes, I have no hope on the presidential candidates right now. The Democratic committee is looking really, really, really bad. The Republicans, they look popular, but they looking really, really scary. So
it's spooky out.
It's really spooky right now with national campaigns and for president. Shit, I'm thinking about voting for, what's his name, Cornel West.
No, it's not.
it's really spooky out here, and we just really got to pay attention. Like Masai said, at the end of the day, it's really up to us to make the difference, to create networks, to create power so we can take care of us. Like, I'm always for people creating power and making sure that we take care of each other.
I love that. Go ahead, you got anything? We can't. No, we can't.
not really going to change the, to be honest, I think things kind of got worse. Like, people stopped fighting less. Biden took office. You know,
and
like,
I said that.
That's a fact. Yeah,
yeah, it is. And it's funny because we was on the steps and all these liberals were clapping their hands like, yay, Biden won. And I was like, there's a lot of work to be done, bro.
That. I'm going
to
be honest.
Just because Biden,
that was
still
so
have the
cringy for me. The parades in the streets because Biden won was really
It was ridiculous because the really thing is he didn't do anything.
Yeah, he just beat like a lesser evil, I guess.
That's
well,
it.
We're worse off now, I think, than we were, you know.
It's
I ask a lot of
so
people
bad.
Say 2021 was the best year of their life. They had the stimulus checks.
Because we got to go home. I just want to say something. I want to say something.
No, it was because of COVID.
No, I got to say something. You have to go based off the vibe of the country at that time, right? Yeah. It's like, because history, again, I'm a history freak. So it's like, I'd go back all the way to like the Great Depression and what's his name? Teddy Roosevelt came out with like the welfare and all this stuff. It's like, the president's job is like, you might not can't affect our lives, trickle down to our individual lives every day, but I feel like it does in a way because just the aura of the country. When Obama was a country, it was just a hopeful, happy time. Jeezy dropping, my president is black. You know, it's a lit time to be outside. Like, it's just about Trump, God bless him, you know what I'm saying? But like, we were happy a little bit. It's like, oh, we inside.
No,
we
about
gotta go
to get,
work. We got a stimmy.
We about to get another stimmy check.
Everybody had a PPP
in November.
Everybody started up a business.
Yeah,
like, it's the truth.
It is what it is.
Listen, because now look, fast forward, ain't no fraud, ain't no PPP loan, nothing.
Who stamps is less than it used to be?
Who stamps down?
We had that money. Like, you see how much money we sent? Oh, we sent like, what, $14 billion over to Israel? But I'm like, they complaining about the stimulus checks. And we like, the money is there because y'all just gave
literally the money is there. And we're struggling. Car notes are up through the roof. I watched the news. The car, I can't even talk. Look, people's cars are getting repo. People can't afford their bills. There's no housing.
It's built into the system. You're talking about car notes. I mean, that's tied to the interest rates. And when we talk about politically, they say, oh, we need to lower interest rates. But there's only one way to do that, and that's people struggling. Like, the only way to lower interest rates is to take money away from the people. So anytime you hear a politician say, oh, we need to lower interest rates, what they mean is they want to find ways to make it harder for people to get income. So even the good news is bad. You know, like, we've created a system where in order to, like, get ahead, things have to get worse.
I mean, and people have to, I feel like a lot of people don't really even understand the electoral politics system either, too. Like, some people
I don't.
Because
I watch video after video.
Working with citizens, you know, working where I work at now, I have, like, learned so much about, like, the electoral politics process and like who actually control, like the president is just the speaker. Like, he's just the representative. Like, he's really not nothing else but that.
Right.
The people that are making decisions are like in the houses.
Right.
Like, so at the end of the day, even though we have a Democratic president, we still have a lot of the Republicans actually running the show because they have the biggest caucus. And they're actually the one putting bills and legislation out and signing them or saying, nope, we're not doing that. And once it gets to his desk, it's either he signs it and veto it and it go back, or it just is what it is. Mm-hmm. So people don't even understand that process. A lot of people just see the president and that's the all say all be all, because no one knows that behind that it's other shit going on.
Yeah.
Like, people that are making decisions for the whole Binghamton area, not just Binghamton, is Mark Molinaro, who is our congressperson, saying, oh, my people are saying they want this, and no, the fuck we don't.
Right.
So it's bigger than that. So hopefully people do pay attention to shit. It's a lot. It's a lot. It's a lot. And some people just don't have the capacity, and the only capacity they have is going to their 9-to-5.
Day by day, they can't take it.
And that's that. But at the end of the day, when you're receiving all of these benefits, the bigger picture is the ones that are signing it for you.
So yeah, I'm inspired. How's everybody feeling today? You guys feeling good? I feel really inspired. Like, we gotta do better as people. So it's time to get into the number one video. It's the number one. Well, what does SpongeBob say?
Number one.
Okay, number one. The number one video is the Supreme Supermunch.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Listen.
Yeah.
I gotta see that video.
Yes, I'm putting it on. Shout out to Supreme Soup. I think you're super creative. I think you're super dope, dude. I've been working with you for a lot of years, but you're not number one because I work with you. You're number one because I genuinely watched your video. I'm like, this guy has got to go places. You just put so much time and effort into your work, dude. So congratulations. You're my first number one video.
Yay! Congratulations.
That's
I love
it.
Let's
get
into
it. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yo, the Supreme suit.
When's the album coming out?
Never. Come on, you don't need to be suspicious. I know that Deuce Deuce is coming out. What do you think about all these rappers having their lyrics used against them in court?
I think it's a travesty.
It is. All these young rappers wasting away their careers in jail. Fuck the police, am I right?
Fuck them.
Fuck them.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Versatile and vicious. My style be drippin' so much, y'all be slippin'. We could hop up on a plane 10 miles a minute and get lost in the aisles like a child that's missing. That's my business. Why y'all always prying in it? Even police wired in and they trying to listen. They heard me talking all that mess from behind the trenches. Taking me to trial with it. Better mind your business, you better. You gotta. You better. You need to
back up.
Yeah.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You gotta.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You better.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You need to
back up.
Yeah. Yeah. Yo, you won't take my energy. What I do give you. Have a bowl of dick soup. Gobble soup. Dick too. Bitch move. Type of shit y'all don't know what to do with. I'ma stack up plaques. Yup. Pass the toothpicks. So, who you in the room with? Who the new chick? Why you do wanna know what it do with a dude dick? Ain't no kissing telling if she in the telly yelling better.
Back up. Back up. Back up. Back up. Back up. This all this mine.
You gotta.
This all this mine.
You better. You need to
back up.
Yeah.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You gotta.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You better.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You need to
back up.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Buffy, where you at? Who you with? When you coming home?
Leave me the fuck alone. Chew on another bone. Soup in another zone. New shit to bump. I produced it and souped it up. Got
what
a noodle
hell
for you to suck up on. Listen, I don't got time for this shit. Go inside, you're tripping. I'm so close to the finish line. I'm sticking out
this
my nose.
This motherfucking trifling ass. Like oh no. Oh no, he is like not. Who the hell is she?
Fine.
This is all
this mine.
You gotta.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You better.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You need a.
Back up.
Yeah. Yeah,
back up,
yeah.
Back up. This is all this mine.
You gotta.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You better.
Fine. This is all this mine.
You need to.
Back up.
Yeah,
back up,
yeah.
Back up.
No. Nope.
What?
No.
What?
Why are you on TV grinding up on all these little hoes?
Those are some kind, respectable young women. They pursuing their college degrees. They getting their money.
You're grinding up on little big booty hoes all on TV.
Yo, you need to mind your business.
Yes. Your business, boss, mom, your business.
Yes, that was so late. That was late.
Shout out to the Supreme. Yes, that was fire, dope. Right? How
that
you guys
fire.
Think of my first countdown?
I think I did it
pretty decent. It really took me a long time to shift through. Okay, first of all, you guys, submit your music. Passion, submit your music. I don't want December to come. My next countdown is going to drop Christmas Eve. I'm flaming it now. My next countdown is going to drop Christmas Eve. That'll be the December one. And so that's how we're gonna do it. It'll be a 2-week window for music submissions, and then after that I need 2 weeks to shift through them, decide the order, and then bring it to you guys. So yeah, the next episode will be December 24th, Christmas Eve. That's a Sunday. And yes, I'm really excited. Thank you guys for being here.
Yeah,
how was
dope.
The first episode of Plugged In?
Dope.
Yes, tell
we
a friend and tell
time.
A friend. I'm not gonna lie, not trying to be a clout chaser, but I'm excited for all your peoples to come on my thing. You know, you vibe.
I actually, there's a lot of folks who actually wanted to reach out and see, you know, how they
yes.
can follow up. You know, even Sue, number one on your countdown,
yeah, uh-huh.
he wrote it. He'd be in the trenches with us. We done got
I
him
am.
Arrested a couple
that's
times.
Crazy.
How
did I got arrested?
It's a small, you know, it's a
so
small
that was,
community.
That was hilarious how we're here talking.
Yeah.
Sue was the number one because
yeah.
Sue is, you know,
that's
he's down
community.
For the
cause. That's community. That's how
that
you build, you know?
Community.
He's down for the cause.
I love it. I'm very happy. I'm very pleased with my first episode, my first countdown. All y'all with an opinion, save it. Nah. You can tell me your opinion, but it really don't matter much. This is 106 and Plugged In, all right? Not 106 in your opinion. I got a nice rubric I'm working with. I think it's nice and fair. Hit me. Submit your music. If you got a question, let me know. Why I was number three? Why I was number one? Yeah. Yeah, just
the point is, you made it on the countdown. And hello. If you made it on the countdown, you fire everybody on
hello.
The countdown.
It was fire.
Was super dope. The music was good.
Great.
The vibe was nice. The videos were amazing.
It was great.
Shout out to the producers, mixers, whoever was involved to making all of that creation.
And we're also going to do honorable mentions. So tune into my Instagram page. I'm going to do honorable mention, give some flowers to people who also deserve that maybe didn't make the countdown. So. Thank y'all for plugging in with me today. We are here at the Outlet Bar and Lounge, sipping on our drinks. All the drinks are empty. Masai bought us pizza. Hey, shout out to Domino's. Yes. We had food. We had drinks. We had candy. We are outside. We had hookah.
This is the standard now. This is the standard now. You can never, you can never have less than this. Everybody
this
gonna come,
is it.
And it could be like, where the snacks? Where the drinks? Where the hookah?
This is, I actually hate that food.
Sorry. You're welcome.
Now that I actually said that, I actually hate that.
Got
but so I'm really excited for what's to come. Hopefully we can have you guys back for some politics with people sometime.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
of course.
Yeah.
You know I'm down.
All right,
y'all, you have been plugged in.
Let's go. Let's go. Get some money. Fuck they plan. I told her take this plan, B, and stop playing. I'm tired of buying jewelry, finna buy some land. They still trying to figure out who I am. Who I be. Pillow talking to these hoes, that shit weak. They say money talk, but